Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, welcome back to my channel. My name is Maya and I'm so happy you're here. Welcome if you're new around here. I post vlogs, series, get ready with me's, and a little bit of everything in between. So of course, if you're into that, like, comment, subscribe, follow me on social media, when you post what I'm about to film or what I'm about to upload on the channel prizes, then of course, say hi. Of course, this vlog was filmed the week that the music industry just had like a weird, sudden, unexpected loss. Obviously, if you are dealing with this loss, this grief, it's okay to grieve the person who you grew up with during the One Direction days and even the solo days. I know that it was a really weird, interesting time given that there were some things going around about him, and as more stuff comes out about his passing, please don't post photos or videos of just things that people don't need to see, things that his son shouldn't see when he grows up and has access to the internet. And please be respectful to not only his son, his friends, his family, and his alleged victims of his abuse, because even though they're never gonna get justice and we're never gonna hear his side of things, it's still like, don't go harass them, please. And yeah, I hope this vlog is a great distraction to you, and I of course will see you guys at the end. This vlog is mostly me just leaving Utopia and going to Halloweentown, which was fun because as y'all know, I love Halloween. I think this we're one more vlog away from Halloween, which I'm excited for. I cannot wait. I cannot wait to see how my costume turns out, and if you want to comment down your costume, please do, even though I'm not going to say what my costume is. Sorry.
Abra Kadabra.
Ooh.
Why is this doing this?
Okay.
We're back home. The vlog is up and PCD is hitting hard right now, and I did not wash this all off. I want to get ready for work and just talk to y'all about what happened. And wow, PCD really hitting hard. I really wish I was back at Utopia. Today's Monday and it is Indigenous People Day. Okay. Let's just talk. I posted the vlog. Hopefully you guys are watching it and enjoying it. This time I actually put in timestamps. I also posted a little story time. Like 2 days after I got back, I think. And that one I was really like, just like, let's go. If you haven't watched that story time, it's about the time I had a Twitter stalker for like 7 years. And I forgot to mention this part. So this person, Boss, didn't watch the video, probably know what the fuck I'm talking about. Boss would always say that she had an active police report with the LAPD because she knew I live in LA. And I said in the video that I knew someone who knew someone in the LAPD, and I also like tried filing a report, but since something was physical and no like actual threats, it was just like, we'll have it, you know, we got you, don't worry, but like, we can't really do anything. She would also say like, I have a report with the LAPD, I'm crying on the phone with them, and then there was never a report on me from where she lived or anybody, because I think like two or three other people also said that they had a report on me, and they're like, you have a clean record, like you're fine. Ooh. My skin is glowing right now, unless it's the filter. I'm using this new Milani primer that has SPF in it, because the NYX one was fine. What is going on here? Like, hello? The NYX one was fine. It's normalized having $10 primers again. Like, what happened to that? When I was doing laundry, I was trying to edit the Get Ready With Me for Utopia, but since I talk so much and the main clip was 18 minutes, I had to keep like breaking it up, but I think I should be done. And of course it should be uploaded by the time you guys are watching this. But yeah, I think I'm like cool on concerts. Please, 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 nobody announce a concert or a tour for the next like 3 months, because not only do I have Halloween, which I just bought my costumes, and yes, costumes is plural, but yeah, I just bought my costumes. I have parties to go to. There's gonna be like a work-ish party, like some of my co like two of my coworkers are throwing a party, but my period's coming, so obviously I can't fucking go. But I do intend on going to a party because I didn't get to go to a party last year. And also I was talking with my twin flame or whatever, and we were like, we need to do a Halloween photo shoot, but I haven't, like, we don't have coordinating schedules, so we're gonna have to like try to like
figure that out for sure. My skin is legit glowing right now.
It's getting like kind of gloomy in LA. Like, I was doing laundry and I was like, it's kind of, it's 70 degrees right now, so of course that calls for some layering up. Not literally, I'm just gonna wear like a sweater to work and call it a day. Like, I don't need a hoodie too. That's OD for sure. For sure. Let's try to get that. Yeah. Yeah. What else is going on? Literally, like, nothing else is going on for sure. I mean, I'm just chilling. I'm just vibing. I'm just doing me. I low-key don't want to wear makeup to work, but I feel like people have today off, so I have to, you know, I have to look good, you know? Where is my concealer that I just saw, like, 2 seconds ago? Here we go. Yeah, my bag is, if y'all can see it, my bag is not organized at all. Like, it is crazy. I do some returns, aka girl math, more shmoney. Tomorrow, I'm gonna go to the horror cafe, which I like to like go to cafes early and just have like the day to just like, you know, be my inner Dora the Explorer type shit. But this cafe opens kind of later than usual cafes. I feel like cafes usually open at like 6 or 5, like, it is, Starbucks open at like 4 or 5 or something like that. And then when I used to work at a cafe, we would open at like, the first cafe I ever worked at, they were like, oh, can you open? And I was like, what time does cafe open? Oh, we open at like 5. No. I think the fuck not, you trick ass bitch. I'm sorry. First of all, I loved it there, for real, for real. But no. Absolutely not. But you know, I'll come in. I can wake up at 5. I don't know about like getting into work at 5. I don't know about that one. I don't know about that one. Also, another cafe I worked at opened at like 6:30. This cafe opens at like 9. Which, cool. I want to see if they updated anything. The last time I went was, I think, like, it wasn't 2 years ago. It was a year ago because it was around the time that Scream 6 was being promoted and stuff. I think I'm actually going to try and possibly succeed blending my concealer with a concealer brush. Let's see how long this takes me. Speaking of makeup, I need a new moisturizer. This, I don't want to use all of this as both a moisturizer and a primer. It is good. I just don't want to, like, use it all for one. Like, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? You know what I mean? So I was like, let me treat myself. As if I haven't been treating myself the past month. Girl, it's not your birthday anymore. Lock in. I was checking out Rode because y'all know Rode is my girl. And if you don't know, Rode came out with these blushes. And yes, it did cause some controversy, but Haley got in the booth with the newborn. Somebody can't relate to that, okay? And they had like these bundles where you can get like a blush and a coordinating lip product with it. And the one I wanted is sold out because it's the prettiest and it's the cuntiest and it's the most fall. So of course, I should have got in when I got in, but then I was like, okay, look at the moisturizer. The moisturizer is $30. And I was like, oh my God. So I'll have to like double check and see what other kind of moisturizer I can get for the low. Because as much as I do love Rode and want to be on their PR list, I don't know if I could justify getting a lip and blush and a moisturizer and have that all be close to $80. Maybe I can though. But like I said, it's Halloween, it's Thanksgiving, it's Black Friday, and I just know for Black Friday, I'm treating myself for sure. And on top of my Halloween costumes, I ordered some new shoes just because, like, I just need some new shoes. Okay, like, I actually needed some new shoes. Don't clock me. Don't clock me. Let's put on some bronzer. My sleep schedule, I think, is back on track. It wasn't on, like, it was fucked up. Okay, I feel like I've been sleeping a lot. And then when I, like, I've been sleeping a lot, and then I stay up with, which then it's just, it's a circle. So yesterday I got like 2 hours of sleep before I had to go into work. That's my bad, but that's really not my bad, because when you want to see somebody, you just take the L, you know what I mean? And I came home, took a nap. Well, actually I stopped by some stores, you know, I got some things, and then I came home, took a fat ass nap. I don't even know what time I went to bed, for real. I was watching Old School Kardashians. I'm on the season. I don't know what season in particular, but it's the season where Kim is pregnant with Northwest. Like, she hasn't even given birth yet. It's probably, I think, it's like springtime that I'm on, because she like officially got divorced from Chris Humphries, which, what the fuck? The marriage wasn't even like a full 3 months. Why did it take them almost 2 years to get officially divorced? And I think she was trying to paint it out as like Chris was kind of the reason why it was taking so long. If that's true, that's kind of fucked up, because honestly, I like watched the marriage. Like, I've been an OG Kardashian fan since it came on. Like, I remember when we would go to the laundromat, I think it coordinated with the days that it was on E. So I would watch it like at the laundromat and just like have a good old kiki time, you know? They weren't meant to be together for longer than 3 months in general. Like, they would fight. He didn't get along with Chloe. Chloe didn't like him. It's just like, I don't think it was a fake marriage. I really do think that she probably just saw past the arguments and whatever. I mean, obviously, I don't know Kim or Chris. Also, it's kind of weird, like, marrying somebody that has the same name as your mom. I don't know about that one, but she did it, I guess. I don't know. It's kind of just, like, fucked up. I don't even know where Chris is. Like, I know Chris Humphries is still around, but, like, what does he do? Like, is he still in basketball? I don't follow basketball, if you couldn't tell. I don't really follow sports like that in general, but, like, does he still play basketball? Like, what does he do? Also, their lifestyles not, like, match up at all, because wasn't he like, I want a simple lifestyle? And she's all like, I'm trying to order my 100th Birkin, babe. Girl, what? Like, this is not for me. She's from Beverly Hills, for crying out loud. Listen, you could take the hills out of the girl, but you can't take the hills out of, like, you could take the girl out of the hills, but you can't take the hills out of the girl. Okay, like, anyways, yeah, so I'm on that. She hasn't given birth to North yet, but she, like, moved in to Chris's house to prepare for North's arrival. And she, I remember this too. This is kind of like a, if you had to be there moment, when she was obsessed with Kylie's Tumblr. And honestly, Kylie was a trendsetter from, like, kind of early on, like, 2013, 2014. She's a trendsetter, because her Tumblr was kind of cut. I was there. It was where I remember it all too well. Like, it was kind of cunt. But Kim was like, she doesn't repost photos of me. And it's like, Kim, I know you're a fashion icon, but you're not the fashion icon. You know what I mean? Like, yes, you are a trendsetter, but you're not the only trendsetter. And, oh my God, I am friends with somebody who wasn't around for, I mean, like, they were around, they just weren't aware of, like, the Tumblr lore from, like, 2011 to, like, 2016, 2017. So it's like, on one side of Tumblr, you had the fashion, you had the magazines, you had the aesthetic, you had the, you know, kind of like the TikTok where it's like clean girl, oh my God, dream apartment in New York, 1,000 bookshelves, big apartment. And then you had the other side, which was like corn. And they didn't, like, censor corn, like. And then you had the ED side, which, unfortunately, I was also on. I was on the corn ED and then some of the fashion side of Tumblr, too. I was mostly on, like, the fan base side. And I was telling my friend, I was like, yeah, Tumblr was crazy. Because it could be, like, 3:30 p.m. on a weekday. I just got home from school. And I'm trying to procrastinate on my homework or whatever. Or, you know, just procrastinate on whatever. Go on Tumblr and I see a photo set of Fifth Harmony, you know, doing the thing, whatever. I scroll down and it's two people going at it. And he was like, wow, that's crazy. And I'm like, yeah, I mean, Oh my god, also, like, when people would have, like, their page, they would have, like, a certain, like, layout, I think that's what it's called. And let me just tell you right now, cracking that code on trying to get, like, a free layout, but it still look and feel cunty, yeah. I don't even know what my layout is now. But, like, back when I first had Tumblr, oh yeah, baby. I remember, especially on Tumblr and Twitter, I would change my layout, like, every few weeks or every month. Like, I was on it. Especially if my fave just came out with a new look or something. Oh, yeah. Best believe that. I feel like I should wash my brushes, too, but, like, that's so much too much. Maybe I should, though. This is a new powder I got. It's, I think I said it already, NYX Can't Stop, Won't Stop. Coming back home was easy breezy beautiful cover girl, but they were like, oh, we're experiencing, you know, get back in your seats, everybody, we're about to experience some light turbulence, which, to my knowledge, I've never experienced turbulence on a flight. I don't know, I probably was knocked out when they said it, and I was like, I'm just in my seat set, babe. Okay. And it kind of just felt like a light earthquake. Like, I felt it go, like, the plane, like, kind of just, like, do, like, a this. Or maybe just, like, a that. And I was like, okay. I think I'm slowly getting over my plane anxiety. Slowly, but not surely. But I need to, like, sit down home in LA and just chill, save. And then we can go back on our next adventure. Or it is reported, speculated, alleged, if you will, that not only is Double A going on a tour, but Beyonce and Lady Gaga are going on a tour because they're both coming out. Or Beyonce already came out with her album, but she didn't, I don't think, on tour this time like she did with Renaissance. Gaga is already, you know, on her fucking Hello Joker promo tour, which honestly, I hate that she's getting most of the hate when it's like, she just got to work. Some of y'all can't relate. Some of y'all, like, she just went to work and did her job and, like, she's getting hit on it. She didn't make the fucking script. So, if anyone has an issue with how the movie went, take it up with the director, the producer, the writer. Don't take it up with the person who just clocked in and locked in. That's so stupid. What? It is also alleged that mother, Miley Cyrus, is doing a Las Vegas residency. So what I'm hearing is I'm going back to Vegas. In Vegas, I feel so at home. Actually, I don't. Vegas is interesting. Vegas is interesting. I remember my aunt was like, would you ever consider moving to Vegas? Like, it's cheaper over there. And honestly, from what I've heard and from what I've seen, the rent prices are similar to LA. You just get, like, a little bit more square footage. But from what I've seen, what I've heard from, like, local residents, they're like, it's not worth it. Like, it's still pretty bad and yada, yada, yada. So, inflation, rent increases, and all that stuff is a nationwide thing, which, how come when I was younger, a cute little studio, maybe not even little, a nice size studio apartment was somewhere between $600 to $800. One bedroom was probably like $1,000 to $1,300, $1,400, depending on where it was and how big it was. And now the price for a studio is $1,000 to $1,400. And nothing, like, it's fucking old, it's fucking creaky. Nothing's been updated since the clowns took over back in 2016. I almost said Trump, but that nigga is a clown for sure. So, like, he also is included. So, like, I'm hoping something can change soon because this is ridiculous, like, for real. It's just insane in the membrane. I did a TikTok where it was, like, looking back on, like, the redemption era I've given myself the past few months, and I truly have given myself a redemption era, and I'm so proud of myself. And I can't wait to see what's next for the last 2 months of 2024, and I hope everybody that is watching is having a great day or night, and I hope that you guys continue being on this ride and what I have next for you guys, because of course it's Halloween, and unfortunately I do have my period, but it's right before Halloween day. Period, pooks. Exactly. We're not gonna have what happened last year. That was so terrible. That was so terrible. Like, I sometimes think about that. I'm just like, that was so terrible. I was this close. But we had a great redemption era. We saw Madison again at the barricade. We didn't go to her tour, but we got a little taste of it. Exactly, Pooks. Anyways, this is the end of the get ready with me to go to work for a short periodically time, but I'm gonna have a time, I'm gonna get paid. So, anyways.
Mwah. I just got free pizza and fries, and I have to make a return, aka more shmoney. What's up, friend sweatshirt, even though it's cold, but it's not. Like, I could've worn a short sleeve, I'm not gonna cap to y'all. We're at the Horror Vibes Cafe. I'm home. Like, I need to work here for real. It's so pretty. It's different from when I came here last year. This is what it looked like when I came here last year. And there's some photos of it. They upgraded it a little bit. I don't know what I'm gonna get. Y'all, these names. I just lost it. A banana mocha latte. And that's Gordy's Home. I feel like I'm uneducated by not knowing what the fuck that is. Or Scissor Hands, which is hazelnut mocha with mocha. I can't see, so don't fuck me. The Annabelle latte is sweet rose. I'm okay on that. Oh, they have the Crystal Lake chai, which is spiced apple chai. If I didn't need to wake up, I would totally get that. And then for pastries, they just have... I might just get like a butter or whatever this one is. It's like chocolate. Okay, so I'm gonna get... I don't like maple. Gordy's Home. I'm gonna have to look up who that is. And then... Oh, they like s'mores too. Oh my god, that scared the fuck out of me. I'll show y'all what I just like looked at. That scared the fuck out of me.
So I ended up getting, they didn't have the one that I said I wanted. I got the Lloyd, which is pretty much pumpkin with no whip. This looks like the Whole Foods, like, coffee. Wait, here you go, Pooks. Anyways, let's try it. Oh, I wish they were hiring. I don't know if they're hiring. It was so dope just to walk in and just see, like, the things that I love. I think this is like cinnamon. That's a lot of that on here. Being an adult is scary because you have free will to do and get whatever the fuck you want. It is 10 a.m. I did not have breakfast, but I had a cookie. They didn't have like chocolate muffins. The muffins they did have, I didn't want. They had like apple and blueberry. Never had an apple muffin. All of this was $13. I'm just gonna take the L on that one. Anyways, I'm gonna go for a little walk slash a return. I've done 2 returns at Target yesterday. I just returned the suitcase I got from TikTok shop because they sent me an extra one. And then I have to return a perfume because I have too many. I truly have too many, so. It's like coldish right now, but an excuse to wear this fucking hoodie apparently. Anyways. I love it.
Is this real? This can't be real. Not gonna show this person's house. I'm gonna try to blur out as much as I can, but I fear I found my best friend. I think I found my soulmate. I don't know. I'm just chilling. I'm like listening to Astroworld.
clearly, and I look up and I just see this big ass fucking Pennywise the Dancing Clown ass statue, and I was like, hold on, hold on, I need to take this in. And then like I see like black and white, and I'm like, what the fuck is that? Art the fucking clown just standing by the door holding a imagine like leaving your house like hella late, and you're like kind of, imagine you're hella fried, baked, sauteed, flipped in motherfucking dip, and you're picking up like DoorDash or something, and you're fried as fuck, you're just like, I want food, and you walk outside to pick up your food, and you see this. I found my person, whoever this is, speak up, show yourself. Because the more and more I walk, the more and more I'm seeing like hella decorations. I think these are my people for real. I busted a sweat for real. My hair is like really frizzy right now. Okay, we're in Ulta. I'm literally only here to return something. But what's wrong with window shopping? Absolutely nothing. Also, I got kind of hot. Not even the side, it just got like really sunny. So, anyways, we're in the perfume section, which is funny because I'm here to return a perfume because I have too many. If my man is watching, I like Prada and this Givenchy perfume. It's the fucking best. It is hella expensive, but literally, I'm not even like joking, it lasted so fucking long when I had it. Like, she's crying, shut up. Wait. Oh, this is new. How come I can't? Hold on. Yeah, this is the right one. Exactly. This spectacular, give me 14 of them right the fuck now. Like, oh my god, this is the perfume that my coworker gave me. Let's see. Also, this sounds like Taylor Swift, but I know it's not Taylor Swift. But I'm not a Swiftie, so I don't really know. So, someone, if this is her, let me know. I'll know because I'll get copyrighted damn bad. Now I'm home and I'm so exhausted. My hair, I need to like take care of it. I just washed it and it's like super like tangled and like it's getting like thicker and longer. Like there's like a baby hair that if I take it apart, it looks like a banging. So that's interesting. I'm exhausted, but I had a lot of fun. I'm gonna take a shower, get zooted, wake fried, fucked up on shoddy a vibe, and watch a horror movie. I need to finish Scream 4 and then figure out what movie I'm gonna post today. I really don't know. I think I might watch It, like the original It, or Gothic. Oh my god, y'all, if you know and like Gothica is like so underrated. Like, it stars Halle Berry, and I need her in more horror movies. Why was she not in more horror movies? Like, I get it could be traumatizing. I don't know if that's the case for her, but like, I need her in more horror movies. Like, it's just so good. It's also like Penelope Cruz. It's just phenomenal. Like, if you've never watched it before, I don't remember what streaming service it's on. If I do post it, I'll put it right here. I think Maya, please get on your Zoom and put what streaming service it's on, because people need to know about this movie. People just really need to know about this movie. But yeah, OG It. And I don't know. I was gonna finish Nightmare on Elm Street, but I feel like it's just like, I don't know. Like, I didn't finish Friday the 13th last year, so who knows? Who truly knows? Honestly, truly, I can't believe it's only Tuesday. Like, kind of fucking tired. But I think I found another spot that I want to go visit, like horror wise. Like, I do want to continue looking at iconic places that horror movies were filmed in or shown, like places that are shown in horror movies. So there's that. I need to like, I'm tempted to go back to Olaplex, like for real. I just don't want to spend a lot of money on hair products. That's the problem with having like hair that has so many fucking needs, because it's fall time, so my hair isn't as dry as it usually is, especially during the summertime. But like, I need a good dry shampoo. I need a good detoxifying shampoo. But I also need a shampoo conditioner that actually hydrates and moisturizes my hair. So it's like, Olaplex, in my opinion, from when I had it, didn't really do that. But it still worked in some ways. I think the only, like, expensive, quote-unquote, shampoo and conditioner for me is Moroccan oil. So fucking good. And it smells so good. And it lasted me, like, over a year. I still have the same hair length. I feel like I've always just had, like a lob type shit. Like, at shoulders or, like, a little bit under shoulders type. So, but yeah. Maybe I was looking at Redken, because I know Redken is, like, a big, people getting that now. I feel like it's always kind of been, like, up there. But why is it $64, bro? Like, is it worth it? Is it worth it? Like, if you know good shampoo conditioners that are great for thick, dry, curly hair that's also bleached slash slightly damaged, don't get keep. I don't get keep. So don't get keep. Also, I always just, like, film right here because, like, this is just, like, it's pretty. Like, I just like it. I have nice eyebrows, in my opinion. And I've also had nice eyes, in my opinion. So, if you don't like it, I don't know what to tell you. What am I talking about? Okay, clearly I need to go to sleep. Also, okay, so important announcement. Important. Not really important, but it's important. I got my ballots in the mail a few days ago. And that's probably the same case for a lot of people. If you are watching this video and you are a subscriber of my channel, or you've been watching my videos, please, please, please don't embarrass us again. Make the right choice. Educate yourself on the choices that are on the ballots that are presented to you for not only your country, but for the state that you live in, because I'm pretty sure we don't all live in California. Please don't. We have 3 weeks. And while I was walking, I was seeing Halloween decorations, but nothing is scarier than seeing a Trump sign. No fucking cap. So yeah, so please educate yourself. Make sure that you are registered to vote in the country, or no, in the state that you are in. And make sure, again, that you are educating yourself on the people that you are voting for slash that are presented on your ballots. And don't forget to turn in your ballots by, is it November 4th or November 5th? I feel like it's always been November 4th. But I keep saying November 5th, editing my get in the booth for real, and put the official date of the election, please. And yeah, I will be crossing my fingers and my toes and keeping a suitcase full just in case. Because I cannot be in a country where a convicted felon rapist and reality TV star host is a fucking president of a country. Like, I remember being 6, 7 years old, so this is 20 years ago, loving The Apprentice, and now hating this man because he hates people like me. So, and I can't believe that there is actual, listen, my fellow black people, I get it. That 1200 changed a lot of niggas' lives. But if you clocked into your job, you could see that money and more every 2 weeks or every week. Like, people are like, Kamala doesn't do anything for black people. First of all, yes, she is. She just presented a new plan and she wants people to not be jailed for marijuana usage. What do you think Trump is doing? He's using you guys as fucking clowns. He don't like us. I don't think, like, where did I see that Trump likes black people? Except for to use us as, like, to push out the narrative that he likes. Like, he doesn't fucking like us. Get it through your... And especially, don't get me started on the Latinos that are voting for Trump. He wants your ass out of this country, for real, for real. And you're standing 10 toes down for him? I am not Latino, but I do have a dad who is not from this country. If he was still alive and he was voting for that man, I would denounce him as my dad. Get it together, please, please, please.
I've never had a PSL from Alfred's before, so we're gonna see if this is good. With Alfred's, you have to, like, mix it in the bottom, and I got cold foam too, because obviously. Now, hold on. It's so good. It's sweet, but not too sweet.
Okay, so not only is this one of the nicest neighborhoods I've ever walked in,
the nicest fucking, hold up, you know, the nicest fucking people live here. Everybody's just like walking their dogs, and then like everybody has said hi or morning to me. What? Mind you, like, this is a bourgeois type of neighborhood, and I'm wearing shorts. They're probably like, oh, I don't know if they think I live here. Maybe I will one day. Anyways, it is so fucking foggy, but I'm surrounded by beautiful nature and beautiful people, so I'm not complaining. So this is how foggy it is at like, what, 10, 11 o'clock. The view is nice. There's actual houses up here, which, girl, I'm barely getting service. Like, I have one bar and Vibes right now texting you. I'm supposed to be walking over here, but it's too close to the fucking door. Like, I'm gonna keep on walking and show more because, yeah. What the fuck am I on right now? This is crazy. This is spooky. Okay, so the fog is literally like covered, bro. This is crazy.
What did I do to myself? It's either we go in the street or we stay in the neighborhood, or there's another, it's like a teensy tiny hill, but the street doesn't really have sidewalks like that. And the street I'm getting to does have like a little, like a sidewalk for a minute. And also like a cute little park, which is why I love just like walking in random neighborhoods, because you just find like the cutest, quietest parks. So it looks like we're gonna stay in the neighborhood. I'm scared because if I come from the street into the neighborhood, it's gonna be like more of like a hill, but like it's not steep. It's actually pretty. Is that a centipede? What is that? It's not gonna be as severe as like where I am now. Like, I'm kind of like up right now, but this is just like me looking, because even if I like, there's not, I feel like I'm not making any sense, am I? Yeah. I've done 2 miles so far, and again, everybody's so friendly. Like, there was this dad who I assume was taking his daughter to school. I don't know what time school starts around here, because it was like 20, not even 20 minutes ago. And he was like, good morning, like smile and everything. And I was like, good morning, like a period, folks. Yeah. And also he was black. We love that. We love seeing the brown and black people in bougie / rich neighborhoods. Exactly. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna stay in the neighborhood, because if we go to a street that doesn't have any sidewalks and we're trying to cut into the neighborhood, there's not that many options, babe. There's only one option other than the street that I'm gonna cut from to the street. So that's just not worth it. Anyways, I didn't know that Madison Beer was on the Saving Grace podcast, so I'm currently watching that. Yeah, need to stop using my camera so much because it only has 2 battery. But yeah, I took off my hoodie because it's not hot, but I was just walking a lot and sweating, and that's kind of really uncomfortable. Oh, this little baby. What time does school start around here? I'm gonna ask that. Spread up on me.
Almost at the city, but I had to stop by the hood for me to say I've never been here before. It's just like surrounded by trees too. I don't know if this is like a real house, but like they have a statue here.
We're at this hood. I've never been here before. You're gonna come with me. I've lived here for 12 years and I've never been here before. So we're gonna go. It's kind of pretty. It's like a deli and a cafe, so. What the hell is this?
And we are home. I'm surely so fucking exhausted. I ended up not trying that cafe because they only had oat and soy milk available. But in the last clip where I basically was like, what is this? There was a TikTok account impersonating me and then commenting under my TikToks. So, but then it got deleted. So either they deleted it or it got reported for impersonation, because obviously, like, what the fuck? They were like, we're gonna go pay you a visit. Okay, because I've heard that one before. it's just so annoying because it's like I made that video and I mean I knew that it would get back to her somehow, but I just was like, I'm over it. Like, I don't need this to continue. I'm not doing anything to you. So for anybody who ever gets a notification or anything from an account and it looks like me or has my name, I have four Instagram accounts. Okay, my main, photo dump, poetry, and closet, which the closet one needs to be deactivated low-key because I don't use that, and any clothes that I am not gonna wear anymore, I'm just gonna donate them because, or like just sell them at Crossroads or something, I don't fucking know. So I have four Instagram accounts. Other than that, I only have one Twitter, one TikTok. I don't use Facebook or Snapchat, but I only have one of those, and also I don't use them. So yeah, that's fun. I ended up going to Whole Foods because I ordered some shoes, if you will, and I needed some iced coffee for the days that I have off, or like we're gonna get up early, you know, get in my Zoom, get in the booth. But anyways, I'm gonna chill for a bit and then go ahead and film the second video. I don't know if the second video is gonna be about Camila or Demi, but I'm gonna film the Demi one right now. I already filmed the Camila one. Maybe I need to refilm it, but yeah. Fun times. I did not mean to ignite old drama, but that's what happens. You know what Future said? They hate when you tell them the truth. I'd rather be realer than you. Obviously, the video struck a chord, so, but just don't be a weirdo. I don't know. Like, first of all, you say that my hair is one way or the other. You say that I'm going to see my dad in hell, and then you impersonate accounts and leak my number. It's just like, okay, you didn't think anything would come from that? I mean, the police didn't come for you because it was all virtual, but anyways, I'm gonna drink my poppy. Okay, so I just got done filming my second video, and I don't even know why, like, I'm about to cry right now. This is so weird. I got a text from one of my best friends saying that Liam Payne passed away. I'm fried. Maybe that's why I'm about to cry. Listen, I know that he was not the best person, boyfriend or fiance, but like 31, like, this is someone who, like, I grew up with. Like, I wasn't a big Directioner, but I loved and enjoyed their music. Oh my god, this is such a weird feeling. Because my friend was a big One Direction fan. Check on your friends. check on your friends. And I can't, like, TMZ, why do you do this? Why? They posted a photo of his body, not of his body, but it was like, hey, like, this is, you see his tattoos. Like, I hope that the family and friends are okay. And I hope that the fellow members are okay. My God, Maya, get it together. Oh my god, if you're a One Direction fan reading this, I hope you're okay. I hope if you need somebody to talk to, I can talk to you. Yeah. You know, this is so sad. Like, oh god. I hope you're okay if you're in his life somehow.
I also got these new shoes. Yes, I'm wearing mismatched socks, but I got these new shoes from Amazon. They're kind of cute, right? I feel a little bit taller. I'm gonna just test these bad boys out.
Is this your after work for me?
For me?
Ah! Wait.
Big step up.
And that is the end of this vlog. Again, I hope you had a great distraction from this vlog. Again, please be respectful of not only the comic section, but the people that were in Liam's life. It's so weird because, like, I've like cried over this. Listen, I did not expect to go through a loss of someone who I listened to in high school before I turned 30. So I think it's just shock. I don't know how to feel about it. If you don't know how to feel about it, let's have a little group chat in the comment section. I don't know. I don't care. Let's do it. Fuck it. I know the law. If you enjoyed this vlog, please, of course, like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. But until then, stay strong, stay safe, YOLO, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!